From tortoises and turtles to leopards and jaguars, here are 15 animals that are often confused for one another. Number 15, moths and butterflies. These insects belong to the same order, so they share some similar traits. That includes starting off their lives as caterpillars and having a similar shape and appearance. But a key way to tell them apart is by their antennae. Moth antennae can appear serrated or feathery, while the butterfly's antennae is club-shaped with bulbous tips. If you can't examine them that closely, look at the wings. Moth wings have a tent-like shape over their abdomen. Butterfly wings cover their backs and fold up vertically. Number 14, llamas and alpacas. Both animals are even-toed ungulates from South America that belong to the same family. But the llama is noticeably larger than the alpaca, with adults weighing more than 400 pounds, that's nearly 200 kilograms, while their cousins weigh around 175 pounds or 79 kilograms or so. But despite the size differential, alpacas produce far more fleece, having been bred over ages to produce the fiber. Llamas are more often used for transport, and the two species can often be seen together, since llamas are often used as a type of guard for livestock. Number 13, snakes and legless lizards. Both of them are reptiles, and both of them can greatly resemble one another. But these lizards and snakes have different ancestries, and their respective limblessness evolved independently over time. Unlike snakes, legless lizards have eyelids and external ear openings, and their tongues aren't forked. Also, unlike some snake species, legless lizards are non-venomous critters. Number 12, aardvarks and anteaters. Wildlife experts tell us that the superficial similarities between the two mammals are the result of a convergent evolution. That's where unrelated species have evolved with similar traits independent of one another. In the case of these critters, their similarities were developed at a great distance. Anteaters are native to South America, while aardvarks are native to Africa, where they're also called the ant bear. Along with the similarly shaped long snouts and an appetite for ants, both animals have sharp claws they use for digging, but the anteater's foreclaws are larger and curved and can also be used for self-defense. Here's one more similarity between the two beasts. Both have names that start with the letter A. Another convergent coincidence, perhaps? Number 11, bees and wasps. Here's one big, painful difference between these two insects. Bees will generally only sting you once, while wasps will zap you multiple times. That also goes for hornets, which are considered to be a type of wasp. Bee bodies are more robust and hairier for collecting pollen, while wasp bodies tend to be smooth, shiny, and shaped like an hourglass. But here's an interesting similarity that is shared between the two critters. Both are closely related to ants. Number 10, seals and sea lions. Both of these animals are classified as pinnipeds, fin-footed marine mammals, and that's where a key difference between the two can be found. Seal flippers tend to be shorter, which forces the critter to travel by crawling on its abdomen, but sea lions have larger flippers that are strong, flexible, and covered with skin. That allows them to essentially walk on the land using all fours. Other differences are with their ears. Sea lions have external ear flaps, while sea lions have no external ears at all. Their social behaviors can differ as well. While seals tend to prefer solitude, sea lions can gather in large, noisy groups comprising of some 1,500 individuals. Would you rather chill like a seal or party like a sea lion? Number 9, donkeys and mules. The confusion between these two equine critters makes sense because a mule is actually part donkey. They're the result of breeding a male donkey or jack with a female horse or mare. Mules often resemble horses with larger bodies than donkeys, along with their tail, teeth, and coats. While donkeys are noted for their stubbornness, mules are said to be more patient, stronger, and more intelligent than either parent. Maybe the greatest difference between the two animals is the matter of sterility. Mules cannot reproduce, although some experts claim fertility is possible. Number 8, African elephants and Asian elephants. Even though they appear more alike than different, African and Asian elephants cannot be interbred. And while they're two of the largest terrestrial mammals extant today, only one is the largest. The African bush elephant can weigh more than 13,000 pounds on average. That's nearly 6,000 kilograms. And they stand more than 13 feet at the shoulder. That's 4 meters. The Asian variety is not exactly tiny, though. They can weigh around 8,800 pounds or 4,000 kilograms, while standing around 9 feet tall at the shoulder. That's 2.7 meters. Aside from their sizes, there are other ways you can tell the two pachyderms apart. Asian elephants have two humps on their head, while their cousins are smooth-headed. And while the African beasts typically have large fan-like ears, their Asian counterparts have ears that are about half that size. Number 7. Hares and rabbits. They greatly resemble one another, so it's no surprise that the critters belong to the same order of mammals. But hares tend to grow larger than rabbits and have stronger legs with larger feet. That's a reason why they tend to outrun their predators. But rabbits will usually face off to their warrens when threatened. Did you know that hares are often called jackrabbits? Number 6. Monkeys and apes. There are many ways to discern the difference between these two species, but maybe the quickest and easiest way is to look for a tail. If the critter doesn't have a tail, it's an ape. If it does have a tail, then it's a monkey. Although there are a few species that do not display the appendage. Overall, monkeys tend to be smaller and run along tree branches, as opposed to apes, who will swing from branch to branch. Apes tend to display more advanced cognitive skills than monkeys and can communicate with humans through sign language. And in terms of genetic similarities, apes are much closer to humans than monkeys. Did you know that common chimpanzees have a genetic makeup that's nearly identical to ours? Number 5. Frogs and toads. Their names are tossed commonly around as if frogs and toads were the same amphibian. Well, in a sense, that's true. Toad is actually a name that is applied to certain frogs. Those animals have skin that is dry, leathery, and covered in bumps, which are often referred to as warts. Frog usually refers to those amphibians with skin that is smooth and wet, giving them a slimy appearance. That complements their habitat, which is more aquatic. Toads can live near the water, but typically stay on land. And while frogs can jump, toads can only hop thanks to their shorter legs. Many experts say the distinction between frogs and toads is more rooted in pop culture than it is in science. What do you think? Number 4. Spiders and insects. Spiders and insects do have a few things in common. Both are invertebrates and both are arthropods. Still, it's incorrect to call a spider an insect, and vice versa. Spiders are arachnid creatures that have 8 legs. Insects have 6 legs along with antennae and wings. Another distinction lies in how their bodies are composed. Insects have a head, thorax, and abdomen for a 3-part structure. Spiders have a body composed of 2 parts, a combined head and thorax, and an abdomen. Have you ever gotten spiders and insects mixed up? Number 3. Alligators and crocodiles. While the two large reptiles do share a marked resemblance, there are still some differences worth noting, and that includes their tolerance for salt water. Crocs have special glands that help them expel excess salt and stay comfortable in saline environments. While gators have similar glands, they're not as well developed, so they tend to favor freshwater environments. The heads of crocodiles can have a longer V-shape, while alligators have a rounded snout with a U-shape. There are differences in their behaviors and their locations too. Crocs in the wild are more aggressive than alligators, and they're more widely distributed across the globe. Gators are only native to 2 places in the world, China and the United States. Number 2. Leopards and jaguars. There's no getting around it. Both of these big cats can make you see spots, so it's no wonder why they're so often mistaken for one another. But the similarities in their coat patterning aside, there are a few stark contrasts between them, and that includes the difference in their size. After the tiger and the lion, the jaguar is recognized as the 3rd largest cat species. They also have a bite force that some sources rank as the strongest of all extant felids, capable of crushing bones. And while jaguars are native to the Americas, leopards are native to the regions of Africa and Asia. As for their coats, the spotted patterns might appear identical, but the rosettes of the jaguar actually have central spots and a larger overall. Just a quick reminder before we wrap up, if you like the content, go ahead and subscribe to our channel. Just click on the red button so you won't miss another great episode. And let us know how you liked this installment. Tell us which animals were your favourites in the comments below. Number 1. Tortoises and turtles. An easy way to tell the difference between these two reptiles is with their habitats. Tortoises dwell on the land, while turtles tend to favour the water. Accordingly, their limbs are adapted for their preferred environments. Tortoises have feet that are short and stumpy, while turtles can have webbed feet for swimming. And some sea turtles have flippers instead of feet. Tortoises are known for their dome-like shape, but turtle shells tend to be flatter and more streamlined. Of course, one huge difference is with their size. Depending on the species, tortoises can weigh more than 100 pounds or 49 kilograms. And the big, lumbering critters will likely outlive their turtle counterparts, with lifespans that can reach 150 years or longer. Turtles are thought to live for around 40 years, give or take. Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you in the next one.